We're down here at the joinery at Old Salem. A joiner is really just another name for a woodworker. The Moravian joiners of Old Salem, 250 years ago, would have been building windows, shutters, doors, staircases, and the furniture for your house. The Moravians were a group of folks that immigrated to Salem from a lot of different places in the world. There are also Native Americans who lived here. There are also enslaved people of African descent who were brought here to this region. So all of those different people brought with them their own cultural flavors. And you see the influence of all those different cultures on the architecture of the buildings. You hear it in the music that was played here, taste it in the food, and you definitely see it in the furniture that they were building as well. So let's go inside and check it out. So today what I wanted to talk to you guys about is one of my favorite pieces of furniture here. This chair was actually built 250 years ago by Moravian joiners. So the chair itself is almost as old as Salem. As we look at it, we can see that the legs are splayed out to the side, but there's also a splay to the back as well. And we call that literally rake and splay. So rake goes to the front and back. Splay goes from side to side. It gives it a lot of stability. So if you imagine this, now I'm not recommending that you necessarily do this. So if you have a brother or sister at home and you stand with your feet together and then push each other on the shoulder, you'd probably fall over. You'd have to catch your balance. But if you, just like this chair is built, if you splay your legs and you broaden your stance and then you push one another on the shoulder, you can catch yourself and you have this nice stability, this framework of stability. And the chair is built just the same way. So I just wanted to break down very quickly how I might lay out these different geometric shapes. And I use a really simple tool, and this would be a really common tool for a joiner of the 18th or early 19th century, and it's called a divider. I use my dividers, just like a compass, and I can find the radius of that circle of the heart, and I can make these two symmetrical circles by rotating around. And then I'll also use just about the same radius here to make the two arcs of the lower part of that heart as well. Now, one of the most sophisticated shapes in this whole chair is the leg, because it's not only an octagon, but it's a tapered octagon. So if we take a look at this leg, we start off with a rectangular prism. But you can imagine that if this chair was built with this big clunky leg, it wouldn't have any grace to it. It wouldn't have any style or artistry. So we're going to take this rectangular prism and break it down and decompose it into this tapered octagon. Now, the first thing I have to do is establish how big this leg needs to be. So I'll use a calipers, and this is just a really simple calipers. I just stretch it apart and I bring it in. Now, this chair really is 250 years old, so I'm not gonna touch it with the calipers, but we'll get just a basic measurement here, and I'll hold that up to my stick of inches or ruler, and it's roughly about 2 inches. So now let's see how much it has to taper as well. So we're gonna go down to the bottom and we're gonna squeeze that in. I'm gonna go right about to what I think that width is. I think it's right about there. And if I hold that up to my stick of inches, it's right about an inch. So we have to reduce that leg down to half of its thickness on the bottom. So that's the first thing we're gonna do. Okay, so we know that our basic stock is square, and we've planed it nice and flat and square, so we know that all of the sides are perpendicular to one another and we have a perfect square. So now we're going to lay out that 1-inch square on the bottom. So what we need to do is superimpose a 1-inch square over a 2-inch square, and it's actually really easy to do. So the marking gauge is just a really simple little tool, and I can move it back and forth, but right now the fence is set at a half of an inch. So if I start to scribe this all the way around, what it's going to do is it's going to mark out a parallel line at a half inch away from the outside square. And so we're going to go all the way around. And so if we take off a half inch and a half inch, that leaves 1 inch in the middle. So just in a matter of seconds, you can lay that square out very quickly. So now that we've established how small we need to taper this, we're going to turn that rectangular prism into a trapezoidal prism. So all I have to do is take my long straight edge And I'm going to extend a line from the outside corner of that square down to the outside corner of the square that we just marked out. So I'm just going to flip it 180 degrees and I'm going to do the exact same thing on the back side of it. So now what we have to do is we've got to reduce this down to the taper that we've drawn out. So we're taking away all of this excess wood here. We're going to take that surface down. Now there's a few different ways I can do it. One is I could plane it. Another is I could hew it with a hewing hatchet. Or I could put it on the shaving horse and I could draw it down with a draw knife. So now that we've taken the two sides down to the taper, we have to do the exact same thing on the opposite two sides. Now if we take a look at it, we should have that perfect square on the bottom, nice small square, and then if we go up to the top, we've got our perfect larger square on the top. So it tapers from about 2 inches to 1 inch. And what I'm going to do is first draw a line with my straight edge from one corner to the other corner. And what I'm doing is decomposing that square into two symmetrical triangles. And so where those triangles meet, the apex of those triangles, is the very center of that square. So to draw the octagon, what we need to do is we need to just find the length of that line from one corner to the very center. And here I'm using a divider again, but you could use a compass. So from each corner, I'm going to draw the quarter of the circumference of a circle. So what we've done is we've made this flower, and every time the arc comes off the side of that leg, it creates a point of the octagon. And so we've got our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 points. So now we've got all 8 planes of our octagon. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So let's just flip this around and let's do the exact same thing on the bottom, on the smaller square. So now that we've got our octagon on the top, our 2-inch octagon, and we've got our 1-inch octagon on the bottom, it's just a matter of taking off these corners. So we want this plane to extend all the way down to this side to make that one surface of the octagon. A joiner would be thinking about the most efficient way that they could be building this chair, because it's what they're doing for a living. And so the faster they can build it, you know, the more money really they can make. And so they could make a gauge that was based on the same ratio as what we drew out with our divider. And so it goes from corner to this point to the corner. And I've laid it out where it's represented by the corner, the point of the octagon, the point of the octagon, and the corner. Now it really is just a matter of taking away that corner and planing it down to this line here. So let's go ahead and do it. That's pretty close, actually. We've got all 4 of those corners planed down, and so there's our octagon. It's not perfect, but it's pretty close. So there's the small side, and there's the top side. Okay, so we've got one leg down and 3 to go. And we've talked a lot about the geometry of this little chair today and how to lay out this octagon. But for an 18th century joiner, all of this would have been very second nature. It's something that they could do pretty quickly. But the next time that you sit on a chair at home, take a look at it and think about the math and the geometry that goes into things that you use every single day.